Hey everyone, it's Alpha Media Yuji, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to fix Facebook two-factor authentication problem, whereby when you're trying to log into your Facebook account, it gives you this message that check your notifications on another device. So first of all, this happens when you set up two-factor authentication on your primary phone, and now you're trying to log into your Facebook account on a different phone. So it will require you to wait for approval or try another way. So there are two solutions to this. The first one is when it asks you to wait for approval and you have your other primary phone already there with you. And the second solution is when you don't have the primary phone but you'd like to log into this Facebook account without having to enter the code. So in this tutorial, I will be showing you how to fix that for both cases, when you have your primary phone and when you don't have your phone. So in case it's your first time, kindly do me a favor, subscribe to my YouTube channel and also turn on the notification bell so that you'll be updated each time I make a new upload. So in the first solution, if you still have your primary device with you, you're going to open your Facebook app and then you log into your account. So from your account, you click on the notification icon. So you will see a notification from Facebook that someone is trying to log in. Let us know if it is you. So you're going to open that notification. So when you open it, Facebook will ask you to confirm whether you're the one trying to log in. So you're just going to click yes, it's me. So when you do that, you'll approve login for the secondary device and you'll be able to log into your Facebook account. Now, in case you don't have your primary device with you, what you're going to do is you're going to click try another way. So the second solution is for you to click try another way and you'll be given different options of accessing your account. So the first one is to approve login from another device, which can't work. Then the second one is to enter a code that will be sent as a text message. Then the third option is for you to use a backup code that you saved. So I'm assuming you don't have access to all those three, so you're going to click on account recovery under need another option. So you click on account recovery, then you will be required to submit a photo of your ID. So you click submit a photo of your ID. So when you do that, you'll be asked to enter first of all an email address that they're going to use for sending you a new login link, and then the other second option will be for you to upload your ID. So the first thing is for you to enter an email address. This should be an address that you're able to access at that instant. So after filling in the email address, you click next. And then now you choose the type of ID to upload. So these are the accepted types of IDs: passport, driver's license, national ID card, and all the rest. So for me, I'm going to choose national ID card. So after choosing the ID that you have, then you scroll down and click next. So from there, you'll be taken to the section where you're going to upload your ID. So you click on upload and you'll be redirected to your phone storage, and then you select the ID, the image of the ID. Then after that, you submit. But make sure that when you're submitting an ID, before you submit, it should be clear and all the four corners should be visible. So after submitting, Facebook will send you an email immediately to confirm receipt of your ID. And this is how it will be. So then after like 30 minutes, 24 hours or less, you will receive another email from Facebook. And the email will be, thank you for submitting your ID. So then they are going to give you a new password that you're going to use for logging into your account, or a link that you're going to click in order for you to be able to log into your account. So the password will be given, and then also a link. So you're going to click on the link which says get back into your account. So when you click on that link, it will ask you whether you want to remember that browser. So if you're going to be using it always, click yes. And if you have your phone number that you used before, you can click yes, but if you don't have, just click no. So then from there, you'll be required whether you want to turn off the two-factor authentication or you want to add a new phone number. So if you want to add another number that you'll be using for receiving the codes, it's okay. Otherwise, you can select turn off two-factor authentication. And in that way, you will be able to log into your Facebook account on any device without having to enter the code. So I hope this video helps you. In case of any other inquiry, you can drop in the comment section. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe in case you haven't. And see you in my coming videos.